motherfucker.
Today we're back with another, yet another nice Moombahton video. But instead of creating Moombahton, what we're gonna do today is answer a very, very, very old, all-time favorite question that everybody that ever made Moombahton asks himself or herself. And that question, my fellow producers, is it all about the 808? No. Well, that wraps up this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Ciao. So today we got this nice little Justin Bieber project right here that I released 2 days ago. It's a nice little Moombahton edit of his latest song, Red Eye, that came out on his album. It sounds a little bit something like this. Hey, you made me pop off every red like confetti. I know it seems strange, you seen it last night and I miss you already. And instead of explaining to you guys how I made this track, we're gonna do something completely different. I'm gonna show you guys how I make my files look beautiful. And with that, I basically mean make my file in a way that for other people it makes sense and it's way easier to find everything back what you made. I'm gonna try to do this in just one take, so without any cuts or whatsoever. And also look at my camera lens, like this shit is crazy. I don't know what happened. Maybe I stepped on it or I dropped it or something, but my camera lens is busted. Not good. But without further ado, let's get right into this musical proposition that we made, shall we? Like I said, I'm gonna try to do this in just one cut only, so let's see if that works. We're gonna start all the way at the top. So what I like to do when I'm done with making my track, first of all, every single track I have here, I try to make something unique. All the way at the top, we got the acapella, then we got the instrumental, we got another lead, then here we got the kick, and everything stays in its own track. I wouldn't ever make the lead here and then put this one over there and this one over there, because that just does not make any sense. So for now, what we're gonna do is basically give everything a name. So this one, track one, is gonna be acapella. Track two is gonna be instrumental. Track three, which is a little drop lead, so I'm gonna call it lead. So now we're done with doing that. As you guys can see right here on the left, I took everything that I used and I gave it a name, except for these automations, because I'm not gonna name the automations that I use. After that, what I like to do is group everything that belongs to each other. So what I do is right click on the top one, I say insert one, and this one I normally call originals. Then I right click on this one again and I say group with above track, and I do the same thing for the instrumental because these two belong to the originals. Make this one small like that, and then there you have it. So if I want to hide the original sounds, I just click on that, and if I want to show them, I just click on that. The lead is itself, it's a lead. The kick is itself, is a kick. And then right here is where I say snares and perks. And all of the snares and perk that I use, I would do the same. So I group with above. And I think that's it. And then we got all the snares and the perks right here. And I do the same for the effects. So I would, it's already done. I would say effects, just like that. And then right here, group. And then right here, I would do the same with the automations. And then I would say exactly the same, group. So right now we got all our original sounds. We got the lead, we got the kick, we got our snares and perks, our effects, and our automations. In this way, it's very easy to see, very easy to hide. We're gonna do exactly the same thing in our effects channel. So what I always do, every single sound that I have is linked, as you guys can see right here, like that. Every single sound is linked to the effect channel. So if I go here, every single sound, as you guys can see, is linked. It doesn't look as nice yet as I want it to be, but we're gonna get there. So the first thing what we're gonna do, we're gonna get a track that's clean, like this one. I'm gonna hold down shift and click. Either that or I could just right click and say rename. Where is it? Here at the top. And this one I would call again originals. And I'll do exactly the same what I did on my playlist. So I'll make a group of everything that belongs in that same category. So originals, just like that. Let's see, we got the a cappella right here. We got the instrumental right here. So these two basically belong to the originals. So I'm gonna select both of them. I'm gonna hold down my command button. I think it's control on Windows, and shift at the same time, and click the ones that I wanna select. I'm gonna right click here and I'm gonna say route to this track only. Then I'm gonna right click on original. I'm gonna go to create group, just like that. This one, I'm gonna uncheck separator. And then basically I want to make a separator here again because this is something else. And now we got a little group with only our originals. The next thing we had was the melody, which is this one, which I wanna make a group for as well. So I'm gonna create a group. I'll say lead, just like that. The kick, do the same thing. Create a group, call it kick. And then we got the snares and perks. Do exactly the same thing. Create group, just like that. I don't want it to separate there, so I'll do like that. I'll see if all of them are linked to either one of them in the snares and perks, or at least to the main snare and perk effect. Until now it's good. And there it stops. So like that. Then I want to make one for the effects, and I don't have any empty ones, so I can select one over here. I can hold down Alt and basically just tap on the left button the whole time until I'm here. I'll do exactly the same thing. I'll say create group. I'll call this effects, like that. Separator off, and then I'll turn this separator on. Let's see. And then link basically all of them except for this one and this one, because I linked those already to something else, like that. And then right now all of those are linked to my effects or something else which is in effects. Now we got that all sorted out, I can start giving them colors. And for me, I don't really care too much what color you give them. I just choose some basic colors, so it's whatever. For this one, for example, the originals, I'm gonna use red, just like that. And then I'm gonna right click and I'm say auto color group, and it will give automatically the color to everything in this little group that we made. Do the same with the lead, but then with a different color. So for this one, let's say I'm gonna use blue. So the lead is blue. The kicks, I always give like a dark color. So let's say like that. Snares, maybe we could make those yellow, like a hi-hat, just like that. And then auto color group. And then the effects, because the effects are weird, I'm gonna make them green, because green is a weird color, like that. So now our effects chain looks like this. Looks way better, way cleaner. And we're gonna do exactly the same right here. We're gonna give everything basically the same color. So the originals we made red, and all the recent colors that you use, you can see here. So this one red, and we're gonna do the same. We're gonna say auto color group. The lead we made blue. The kick, we made that ugly dark brown, whatever, or orange. This one yellow, just like that. Auto color, so all of the things right here get the same color. The effects, we made green because that's a weird color, just like that. And then the automations I always make in a sort of silver, so I just take whatever color and go all the way up, just like that. And then it becomes like a sort of white silver-ish color. And now, just like that, now finally it makes more sense. It looks way better. You got everything that belongs with each other in the same group, and everything that belongs with each other has the same color. And in that way, it's way easier to find anything that you made basically in the project. But that's basically all for this video. I just wanted to show you guys how I make my own project. I don't like this yellow, by the way. It looks very ugly, but it's all okay. It's all good. I'm gonna leave a link to the FOP so you guys can have a look yourself, so you guys can see how I did it with the colors, how I did it with the effects, and whatever and even how I made this song. It's very, very simple, very easy, but very catchy. If you're new, don't forget to subscribe to this channel and put that little post notification bell on so you're always up to date with whenever I drop a new video. And if this is helpful for you, don't forget to leave a comment down low. Let me know what you thought. And put a like on this video so YouTube algorithm will boost my video to even more people on this planet. But that's basically it for this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Ciao.